Hello, good morning everyone. So we will let Ethan, Dimas from Ethan, will be our main speaker for today. So he will take over and start the session. Hi Dimas.
Hello Kyle.
Okay.
So okay, thank you. Okay, let me share my screen. Okay, just want to double check Kyle, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, good morning everyone. Good to see you. My name is Dimas. I'm the pre-sales from Aten Taiwan. And first, I would like to thank you, Simply Connect team, to invite me here for sharing the Zero Touch Data Center solution from Aten. And then this is the agenda for today. So I will start with data center overview. What is a Zero Touch solution data center? And then I will briefly introduce Aten Data Center solution. And later, Kyle will share the case studies. And then I will also introduce the new product introduction. And later on, we will close with demo session and Q&A. And then first, I would like to start with the overview components of the data center. This one I will just go through briefly. So we have the system include the basic infrastructure, that it will have the cabinet for the servers, cable, and fire extinguishing system. And then they will have like a complete power supply and distribution system. For example, the UPS, ATS, power distribution, and battery. And then they will also include the refrigeration system to make sure that the airflow and the temperature was kept to a suitable level for the data center equipment. So they will have a precious air conditioner, proximal refrigeration, high efficiency. And then they will have a monitoring system, where it have a management system and server, temperature and humidity sensor, smoke detector, and CCTV. Next is the data center industry trends. So the immense amount of data needed to support all these activities in the data center require not only a growing number of data centers, but also a new kind that will be built and how to manage them. So we will have increasing adoption of over IP solution, also with the demand of increased security, because security is a top concern for the newly built data center. And then the rise of high density data center, and also the rise of industrial Internet of Things, and also the desire for green data centers, where you can also save power in the data center. Next, we will start with the zero-touch solution for data center. So before I start, I would like to share some key challenges for the data center or server room management solution. So here are some of the key challenges. Is the solution must be flexible. So in case you want to scale the data center required for business that keeps evolving and wants to service new customer with the new applications. And the solutions are now expected to add demonstrable business value via tech innovation. And IT management is no longer just about maintenance. The third one is security concern. So the solution must take care for the security concerns that are multi-layer and complex as skyrocketing cybercrime fuels industry urgency. And the solution should be adaptable to specific consideration based on the industry by industry approach. And then also solutions should be geared towards delivering the best user experience. Also for either the remote administrators or the support staff with optimized video performance. So we would like to share our DCIM solution to help tackle these key challenges. So device in data centers, for example, like servers, serial devices such as network switch, power, and generic devices. This is where we come for to help solve this management problem using our KVM over IP switch, serial console server, and our intelligent video series. And then all of those will be monitoring by our central management software called the CC2000. And we also have the recording software for troubleshooting and auditing called the CCPSR. So first, what is a zero touch solution? So it's a data center solution where you can maintain the server uptime in remote location, where you don't need to go directly inside the site. Or maybe if you have several different sites located across the country, you don't need to have on-site engineer, that many on-site engineer, where you can all have maybe a few engineers in the headquarter to take care of the problem or issue in the remote location. And then also you will equip by the KVM over IP solution and some devices from ATN, and also the software where you can use the software to help you schedule the tasks at hand. For example, you want to reboot the servers, you want to upgrade the firmware, where you don't need to go to the site, where you can just put the tasks into the CC2000, for example, and then the software will do it for you when it's time for you to upgrade the firmware, for example. And then it's very beneficial for application where it's impractical to have an IT person on site, because maybe you have a sheer number of sets involved. And then I would like to share our solution in action for Zero Touch solution. So this is a remote server room management with intelligent power control for a subway system. So a transportation company runs 3 metro lines with a combined network of 60 stations. And then each station has its own server room and passenger information system that needs to be controlled centrally from a single location. So at first, the challenges we face is we need to provide centralized controls of servers, and then the administrator need to monitor the video output of multiple servers on one screen. And also requires virtual media, and also remotely monitor and manage the power supply to each server. So starting from these challenges, we have the solution. We are using the over IP solution to centralize management for remote server rooms across a widely distributed multi-hub transportation network that have 60 stations. And then the solution can all be accessed and managed using CC2000. So it's very flexible and efficient. And then also the power management components provide the means to monitor real-time, for example, like the parameter like current, voltage, power usage, power consumption, and circuit breaker status. And then this is the one of the examples of the diagram from the central control room. On the top left, as you can see, we are using like a console station where you can monitor using our KVM over IP switch. And then this is a non-PC solution, means you don't need to have like a PC or a laptop to have a, like a remote connection. You can just use this simple operating system free, Java free console that you can access the KVM over IP switch. And then in the station server room, you can see that it has the 2 remote access 16 port KVM over IP connecting to, for example, like 8 servers, and then you will have like a UPS. We have a LCD KVM. If a local connection is needed, then it will be possible by using the LCD KVM. And then we also have the serial console server to connect to the distribution switch and access switch. So this is a simple diagram, and on the left is all the devices that we are using. For the PDU, we are using 32 ampere, 24 outlet method and switch eco PDU to distribute and manage the power. Then let's move to the solution for big data center. So what can ATEN do for your server room? First is you can have a remotely centralized management and access. So you can manage all your system from one software, from one dashboard, and also access all of it. Then next is security. We have several layers of security, for example, like the IP blacklist and whitelist. And then we also have like third-party authentication, and even we have a CC2000 authentication. So it can also help you to minimize downtime because you can access the servers quickly from your remote site. Okay, and then the key factors of a good data center. So what is a good data center is where you can have access to the server, monitoring and redundancy, cable management, and then for the environment where you can also monitor like humidity and temperature, airflow, and do analysis. Next is the power distribution unit. So let's start with our solution now. So we are going deeper into the ATEN solution. Now I will start with the power distribution unit. So for the first solution is the power distribution unit. So here you can see our PDU where you can supply power to the servers, and then we can connect it to the environmental sensors and also door sensor. And you can also connect it to the network directly to manage using a PC, or you can also combine it with our software solution called the Ecodis. And then here you can do remote power outlet control. You can power on, power off, and do power cycle by individual outlets. And you can have real-time current voltage and power usage displayed in a browser-based UI for monitoring at the outlet level. And then we have network interfaces with several protocol that we can support. And then one of the important things is the power on sequencing, where users can set up the power on sequence and delay time for its port to allow equipment to be turned on in the proper order. And then next is one of the feature I would like to highlight from our video, since our video have several features. So this is one, I want to highlight power proactive overload protection. So we have this kind of technology we call the POP. So it's a proactive overload protection. So when a power overloading condition is detected, if we are using a with POP protection, then we can handle one server maybe have a problem with overloading. So it will have overcurrent, and then we can shut down directly those server. And then other PDUs without this kind of protection, they will try first to turn off all the ports. So you might have some problem with your server where it is turned down automatically by the PDU and you didn't have the time to save or backup some of the things. And then for this, you can have several settings. You can enable the POP for last in, first out, means that the last port that have the issue, means that you will have one in port, maybe you turn on the server that have overloading and it will turn off directly that port. And then you can also enable the priority mode. Priority mode means that you can have a list of servers where if there is some problem related to the power, you want that servers to be turned off first. Turn off means that you don't suddenly like cut off the power, but PDU will tell the PC to shut down. So we have like a simple services, like a simple software that you can install at the server. So it's secure. And then it will help you to communicate with the PDU to turn off the servers before the PDU cuts off the power. And we have different kind of settings, like setting A, B, and C, depends on what you require. And then next is we have the monitoring for the environment. So we have a sensor. As of now, we will have the sensor to monitor temperature, humidity, pressure, door security. Security means the door sensor, and then water leakage. So we want to make sure the servers run smoothly, that we can monitor all these five key things where it's necessary to that we know in the data center. Okay, next is the EcoDC. So this is a web-based application where you can have like a simple dashboard where you will be able to see the power, thermal, pressure, humidity information inside the data center. You can also see the two-dimensional like rack map inside the data center, where you can see which rack have this kind of PDU. And then you can have also multi-role and authorization. You can create user, administrator, and then multi-layer of layout design. So you can change the layout. And then we will provide with the like information like RCI and RTI, the rack cooling index and return temperature index, and also provide you the energy report, for example, daily, weekly, or monthly, and yearly, so you will understand the power consumption inside the data center. So this is the diagram, so you can have all the PDU set the data center equipped with the sensor, and then it will provide the EcoDC all the necessary information, and it will share with you all the data. And then since it will be connected through the network, so you can access it anywhere. Okay, next is the KPM over IP, KN, and serial network server, where we call the SN. So this is our A10 KPM over IP switch. So we are using advanced FPGA graphic processor. So as of now, we can reach the Full HD resolution. And then we also have the panel array mode where you can see all 16 screen inside the single, all 16 PC or servers, the display inside the single screen. So you can see whether the server is working correctly, running smoothly or not. And then we also have high grade security because we support the FIPS 140.2 level 1. And then we also have certified open SSL cryptographic module. And then this unit also support the TLS 1.2 and also RSA 2014. And then how do you access the server using our KN? So for example, let's take one of our A10 KVM models called the KN8164V. It's a 8 remote channel, 64 port support. And then we can have a dongle. We called it the KVM adapter cable, connect to the PC or server. And then we can have access through the network. And then we can have the web UI. Web UI means that you can have something like a simple Google Chrome or Mozilla Firefox, like a major browser, where you can access the server using that browser. So you can open a new tab in the Google Chrome, for example, and connect and control. You can see the display of the server and then control with keyboard and mouse. Or if you don't want to have the PC inside your control room, then you can have what we call the KVM over IP console station, where you can use this single unit to connect to up to 64 KVM at the same time. So you can have to connect all those KN inside the data center and then have all managed by the single KVM over IP console station. And this unit, we have the single display, dual display, and if you need more, you can have up to 4 display that have boundless switching by cascading to units. And then you will see the demo later on using this KVM over IP console station. And then why using our KVM over IP solution? We have multiple models and broad compatibility because we have VGA, DJI HDMI, DP, and serial, and we already now have the USB Type-C that later I will introduce to you. And then we have redundancy design. We designed it to have dual PSU and LAN, and also redundant access from the OAuth open management. For example, like a modem, using modem connection, and also a laptop to USB console, or we call the LUC. And we have the secure and centralized access. We have the secure remote access and centralized authentication and authorization. And we have BIOS level control. Since it's a hardware solution, the differences between the hardware and software solution is for software, you might not be able to access the BIOS if the server has some issue. And then we will be able to have virtual media connection, so you can have software deployment using this virtual media. We have panel array, so you can check all the server condition from the panel array mode. And then we will have mobility support, where you might want to have something like an iPad, and then you can access the KN from anywhere. And then this is the console station in detail. So we have 4 version that have single output like VGA or HDMI, and then we will have dual output, one with the VGA and HDMI, the other with the dual HDMI. So you can have boundless switching between the two console station. So if you are using a single dual output, you can have boundless switching between two PC. And then if you are using two console station and you cascade the console station with each other, means you are able to do boundless switching up to 4 screens. So you can handle or manage 4 PC server at the same time and just move the mouse across the screen to switch between those PC. And it is a Java-free hardware console, so you don't need to worry. And so they will use proprietary operating system inside that it will have like a high security. And also supported the panel remote. So the key point of this panel remote, the differences with the KN is you can have and arrange the panel remote like what you want. So you can arrange a panel array consists of several KVM over IP inside, and you can rearrange all this all this panel array inside the panel remote. So this is the example of the connection diagram. So before using this console station, you might have a PC or a laptop connecting using a Win client or Java client through LAN. And then now you can have connection using a KVM over IP console like this one. That's for our KN. So next is our SN. So this is a serial console server where you can manage, for example, like network switches, bandwidth management devices, firewall, and then even like this, using a single cat pipe for the network switch or like a console cable for a PC, for example. So using this one, you can manage a lot of different serial network devices. So we have 8 to 48 port serial console server. And then the key feature is it's highly secure and centralized, have secure for security for the AES and FPS, and you can integrate it with the third-party authentication like AD, LDAP, and Redis. And then you can do direct connection to Cisco switches without using rollover cable. So if you remember, maybe in the old times, you have to use the Cisco rollover cables, and then you have to use like RJ45, connect to like RJ45 to DB9 converter and connect to the console cable. But now using this SN, you can just directly connect the Cat5 cables directly from the SN to the Cisco switches. And then it's also support other network switches that use the same pin out as Cisco switches. That maybe is almost every network switch major brand nowadays, they use the Cisco switch pin out. So we will support majority of the network switches. And then we also support versatile operating modes. So we will have different kind of operating modes for console management and industrial automation. So we have support, for example, like the real COM port and also TCP server or client. Okay, that's for our hardware solution. So now let's move to our software solution. So I will start with the CC2000. So this is a centralized management software or DCIF. And then as you can imagine that.
Okay, yes. Before we move on, I know if anyone have any question.
Yeah, I think. Oh. Okay.
Yeah, you can unmute yourself and ask a question if you have any.
Okay. I just saw. Okay. Does my sounds clear, or maybe I will remove my mask? Yeah. Is it okay? Then if okay, I will remove my mask. Maybe it would be better.
Okay, if no question, then we will proceed.
Okay, if no question, we will continue. Okay, so for the CC2000, as I can see, I have explained before, so you now already know the hardware solution from A10, like the KN, KVM over IP switch, serial network server, and also the PDU. Now we would like to have something like a software that can manage all of those, and then we will have what we call the CC2000. So we can install it inside the CC2000 primary server. So you can install it on any server that have like a Windows or Linux. So we support both operating system. And then we will have also the CC2000 secondary servers for redundancy. And then the administrator or the user, they can use a browser to connect remotely to the CC2000 server and manage and do monitoring from the dashboard using a major browser nowadays. So this is the product introduction. So we have a brand new HTML5 user interface for a better user experience, and we improve the dashboard to inspect important info at a glance. So this is the dashboard. So you can see all the important information first, like device status. So you want to make sure all the device status is good and whether there is an event related to the devices, and then who is online, that people using the CC2000. Next is the task, whether task is succeed or fail. And then for the selling point itself, we have a centralized management with A10 over IP KVM, PDU, virtual machine. So if you have virtual machine, we can also support it, blend server, and more. And then the dashboard, I've explained, and then also the server redundancy through primary and secondary servers. And then next, to run a data center, the management of the following are considered. So this is what we need to consider. So for the power and monitoring part, we can use the PDU, PE series, UPS, and Echo DC. And for the devices like this server, PC or the network switches or serial network devices. We can use the KVM and integrate it with the KA2, and we can control everything using the CC2000. And if you want to have monitoring to increase the security inside the data center, then you can use the CCPSR. And then we also have other series that is closely related for monitoring and command center called the KPM or the KE series. We will not include in this presentation. And then for the diagram itself, for the CC2000, we have the out-of-band management, in-band management, power control, and threshold machines. So for the out-of-band management, we can control all the ATEN devices that have over IP support. And then we have the in-band management, where you can have IP tools like RDP, VNC, SSH, Telnet, and web that we can all add into the CC2000. And you can call or have a connection from the CC2000 to the IP tools. And then you can have support for the service processor, for example, SPILO, IDRAC, IPMI, IMM, and RSA, where you can integrate it with our CC2000. And then for feature power control, of course, we can support our own PDU, PE series. And then for the virtual machines, we can have support for the virtual servers. For example, VMware vSphere, Microsoft Hyper-V, and the Citrix Zen server. So you can add all those virtual servers into the CC2000. And then from that, you can have some degree of control to the virtual servers and even open like a remote connection to those virtual servers. So it's really convenient because you can access everything from the CC2000. So to summarize, it's a secure single portal and single sign-on to consolidate the management of ATEN devices, service processor, blade chassis, virtual servers, and we also have some support for the APC PDUs. And then for the security itself, we will have a secure web connection for the client side using the TLS 1.2 and RSA 2048-bit certificate. And we also support the certificate signed from the third-party authorities, where you can upload it into the CC2000. From the CC2000 itself, you can have IP or MAC addresses blocking, virtual media security blocking. So this is to prevent user just connecting using a virtual media. So if he doesn't have like the privilege to have the virtual media connection, then it will be blocked by the CC2000. We have configurable failed login attempts and logout. And we have also strong user password authentication and configurable user session timeout. And then from the KVM itself, we have the AES 256-bit encryption. And we use a proprietary video format. So if he takes the packet or capture the data from the network switch, he will not be able to have the video. It's not like using the compress, video compression method like the H.264. And then next is the service redundancy. So for the primary or secondary architecture, you can have up to 31 secondary servers. And then the configuration between those primary and secondary will be synced periodically. So in case the primary fails, whether it's have lost connection, the server reboots or something, then connection between the devices and primary switches to one of the secondary servers, and it will keep the data until the primary returns and return and sync again with the primary servers. Next is the CCPSR. So this is in case some of the user wants to increase the degree of security by using our video session recording software. So it can record user session from a system boot up, with that even if the user reset the server, turn on, turn off the server, it will still record the servers. When user access those servers using our IP KVM switches and serial console server. And then this will be useful for incident investigation. So you can easily watch through the capture session so you can trace the trouble and solve the problem. And then we have the live view function to provide real-time monitoring of user sessions that are being recorded. So when some of the user maybe login to the one of the servers, and then maybe the administrator wants to make sure that he does everything correctly, he can do the live view to see what the user is doing. And then this also have the CCPSR also have the service failover, so it will also design to have the primary and secondary architecture. So for the product introduction, it's also using the HTML5, and then we have the live view for monitoring multiple KVM port. So it's like this. So if imagine there will be like 4 user connecting to 4 different server, so you can see all what they are doing inside the server. And then continuous recording without opening any client. So it's just as long as someone login through the KVM, accessing the servers inside the data center, then the session will be recorded. So we can use this, we can use this to troubleshoot, to audit, and then you can use for training, maybe you can do something and record it, and also for real-time monitoring. So the connection will be the client, will have a connection from to the KVM, and then everything in between will be recorded by the CCPSR. And then this is the only KVM recorder in the market. So as you see, we might have monitoring for the operating system directly can install software, but in case the server reboots and then someone do something in the BIOS, it will not be recorded. So we use our KVM to be able also to do KVM recording. And then this is the full application. So you can have the KN connect to the server and also serial devices, for example. And then for the out-of-band management, you can have local access, remote access. And then you can also have CC2000 server while also having the CCPSR server to help you with the security to record all the user session. And then for the user session itself, it can record a video of the screen display and logs the keystrokes, mouse clicks, and audio operation. And then it is non-intrusive. It requires neither software nor driver installation on the computers because we are using our own KVM to do this. So you don't need to worry, you don't need to install anything in the server as long as the user connects through the system using our KVM, then it can record. So besides local user account, so CCPSR also support external authentication like LDAP and Redis. And then you can also have the role based on the super administrator, administrator and user to have different access privilege control. Okay, that's for the introduction of our Ethan data center solution. So now I would like to move to the new product introduction. So this year, we also release some of new product related to our data center solution. So I think if there's no question, then I will continue to the MPI. So we just okay. We have some fun too. Okay. So we just now I share with you the over IP console station. Okay, I have some question. Maybe I can, answer this first. So what is storage size requires for the CCPSR server to record an KN IP over KVM which link up with 8 servers? Yes, 1 terabyte will be recommended. And then if you are interested to know how big the size of the recording, later I will ask SimpliConnect to share it with you. We have the diagram for different kind of application using the CCPSR. For example, maybe the user only open Windows, changing some settings, then the video size will be very small. And then it will be different with someone maybe who opens the server through the CCPSR and do like maybe monitoring like CCTV or maybe watch checking some videos, then the size will be different. But 1 terabyte is recommended because nowadays I think 1 terabyte already cheap enough for the storage. And then in the CCPSR, you can have like a settings where if it's full, it will be able to either stop recording or the second will be deleting the first video you record or the last one. It depends on what you prefer. And then later on, if you are interested, I will share with the SimpliConnect team, and then SimpliConnect team will share what kind of bandwidth needed and what kind of storage size suitable for the CCPSR. Okay, so I hope it can answer your question. Okay, let's continue with the new product introduction. So we recently update the software capability of the over IP console station. So now we call it the R2, which is the revision number 2. So if you remember, it's a Java-free KVM over IP console to manage our KVM over IP devices. So the key features that we add is it can support the extended desktop. Later I will share with you what it is. It can do share script and also do telnet or SSH connection. So for the connection diagram, I will go through briefly. It can do control like one-to-one, many to one, so you can have one console station and control a lot of devices. You can have something like a splitter, one to many, so you can have multiple console station connect to the same KVM. And you can have many to many or matrix. So for the extended desktop, you can have the multiple view function. So multiple view here means that you can have like one PC that maybe have two output. So you can have two monitor to see them. So you can connect the KVM over IP switch using two dongles to connect to the same PC, and then you can set this up to combine like a multi view, and then by using the KVM console station, you can have the multi port preview, and then when you connect to this PC, then it will show both screen immediately using the console station. So when you connect to this PC, you can show it to both of your monitor at the same time, like this. So you can connect using the KVM through the network using our console station, and then you can connect to this PC and it will show both screen at the same time, like the extended desktop, like this. Next is the share screen function. So we have a share screen function where you can push the content of your screen, for example, from operator A, you can share screen, and then to the operator B, and then he or she can accept those content. Either you want to share it in the primary display or the secondary display. You can also do pull. Pull means you can also get the content from your colleagues, and then you can show it to your screen. And then using this feature allows us to have this capability where you can share the content into the big screen. So if you have a big TV for all operators to see, you can share. If you have some emergency or critical events, you would like other operators to know. And you can even have maybe connect to the video wall system using the K8280T as the input and show it into the big screen or big TV video wall. Then you can have telnet SSH connection. So you can connect to console devices directly using telnet or SSH connection. So you can add like a serial devices into the console, and then you can have a telnet or SSH connection to those devices. For example, like to our SN, you can add those SN devices and connect using SSH, or you can have other connection to our devices like this. So you can have SN 3001 connect to the RS232 of our KVM multi-view, and then now you can control this KVM multi-view to switch the content or change the settings. And then coming soon, we will later on have the integration for the RDP VNC connection. So you can imagine that you can control the PC connecting to the KVM using our KVM over IP console. However, you can also directly connect to some PC. Maybe you would prefer to have the RDP or VNC connection to the server or to the virtual machine. And then so some small enhancements we do is, for example, the lock screen password. And then, so you can have a lock screen, and then you can have panel array, and where you can change the order of KVM ports. So you can arrange to what you like, and also virtual media support. And then we also improve the compatibility because we keep releasing the single KVM for IP called the CN9000 and CN9050 up to full HD. And then also support the CM1284 that you can see all these console station into a quad view and use a single mouse to control 4 of them. Next is the CC2000. the CC2000, and then we just improve the CC2000 version 3.3, and then we improve the video outlet control from the client, and we have the web client supports CC2000 proxy function, and it will support our newly released KVM over IP dongle called the 783 and 7174. And also later on the newly released PG series video. So for the key feature, now we can add, so this I'll skip, we can now add into this client where you can do video control to turn on, turn off, or restart the outlet directly from the client. Next, we can have the web client that can support the CC2000 proxy function. So now you can connect to another network, and then from that network, you can have the connection to the server. And then for the compatibility and enhancement, we will support the USB Type-C KVM adapter, and also the KVM adapter module with local console. And then we can have the browse and group only. This is for the third-party authentication. So to help them, we add this to reduce the waiting time to show group or user list. And then we also add the grand default button in case the administrator want to add new ATEN devices and then just want to assign identical privileges to multiple ATEN devices or a user. So you can click this grand default function. And then another compatibility enhancements is if you remember that before we are using Java client, and then now since we add the web client also to our CC2000, then you will not need to download the launcher of Java client anymore. So you can just click the settings, always use web client, and then you will not need to deal with this Java launcher. Okay, that's for CC2000. Next is the K7174. So this is the connection normally to the server using our KN, for example, using the VGA dongle. So it's using KA7170. And then for example, if there is a requirement to have KA7174, or for example like this, then you can have the connection to the server where you can also have a local console using this single KVM adapter dongle. So this is the connection diagram. So you can have KVM signal through this, and then you can do the local or remote control. And then for the RS232 signal, you can bypass through it, whether you can connect to a touchscreen or RS232 mouse. And then we have the privilege mode, where you can change the setting based on the priority. If you set local first, means that the people in the local console will have higher priority than the remote side. So when I do something in the local console, the remote side will not be able to do anything. And then the other way around, we have the remote first, and the third one, we have first come, first serve. And then it will have OSD notification where someone else is using. And then we also have like a control button. So this button's purpose, if you want to have like a emergency button where it will disconnect everyone from the remote site so that you will have full control from the local console, then you can have this button. So you can just press and then control using the local console. So this is the brief introduction regarding the spec. It can support up to full HD, and it can support legacy PS2 keyboard and mouse for old generation server. And then it can also support the RS232 local console, including mouse and touchpad. For the target application, can be in the server room or the production line. Okay, next is the KA7183. So this is a dongle that can support the USB-C interface. So we called it the USB-C Virtual Media KVM Adapter. It can support USB-C interface, maximum resolution of Full HD at 60Hz, and can reach 50 meters, and it can support also virtual media and also audio. So we are using a single connection for KVM, virtual media, and audio signals. And it can support Rex mount, so we have this kind of hook here that you can put into the Rex mount. and also by releasing these devices, now we can connect to all of different interfaces inside the data center. So this is a simple connection diagram through the KN. KN PC connect to the KN, KN connect to the PC using the 7183. And then for the target application itself, you can use it inside the PC, notebook, tablet, or cell phone assembly line. So the production of products with USB Type-C. So you can have the operator to test, to install the software, to do configuration using the KVM over IP switch on multiple products. Since our KVM over IP switch also supports the broadcast mode, where when you move the mouse and keyboard, it will send the signal to all the port connecting to it. So it's really useful to reduce the time to test and install the software into the PC, notebook, or tablet, or even cell phone. And for the studio or video editor, they can remotely connect to their powerful workstation and then maybe do some video rendering, for example. Okay, that's all from my part. So I will move the control to Kyle from Simply Connect. Okay. Does the Type-C dongle support phones or tablet? Yes, it can also support the phones or tablets. And you have, okay.
Hi, so we'll go to a short case study that we have done in Singapore. Okay. So this is one of the deployment in Singapore, which is under an oil and gas industrial company. Yeah, so they have a redundant they server for CC2000 and they deploy multiple sites for to control some refinery site and some different branch office. Yeah. Okay. In the next slide. Okay. So their HQ is in CDB area. Actually, inside is in a Millennium Tower. Okay, so then they deploy the CC2000 primary server in the HQ there, right? Then we have also, they also have a site office in Jurong Island, which is some refinery plant. Okay, and there's one at Pulau Barok, and there's another site office. They deploy the secondary CC2000 server. In case anything happened to the primary server, the CC2000 secondary server will take over. So just a recap, CC2000 is a centralized management software. So the user can actually remote in one platform and control all the servers connected to this server and the KVM also connected to this server, right? All these are connected to internet or VPN. So the administrator actually do not need to have to be in the HQ. In fact, they can be at home during the pandemic. I think they also work from home, then they can remotely VPN back to the office and support the site requirement. So the solution today we're talking about zero touch is that you do not need to have a physical attendance to support the site that require your support, right? So this is just some simple example. So not only on the gas industry, we have multiple government sites that deploy this kind of solutions with CC2000 and even the CCVSR and also some corporate company. Yeah. So we want to emphasize this one is today we're talking about data center solution, but it is not restricted only to bigger scale deployment. We also have customer that like some IT administrator, some SI that deploy kiosks in smaller scale, so they also use a single unit of IP KVM installed in their office. In case anything happens, they can remotely support, right? So you can consider this one is not only for big scale only, so in smaller scale also we can do that, right? So then the next one we'll pass to move on to demo if you don't have any questions. Okay, so this demo session this setup. This I'm show the setup for the demo session. So most will have a brief introduction to you on this one.
Okay. I will stop sharing first. Okay, so Miss can share.
You share the screen.
Okay. I will,
Dimas.
Yes.
Yeah, I think you share the screen for the connection diagram. Yeah.
Oh, so we can share both to the Zoom?
No. We explain the connection first.
Okay, can.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, let me share the screen again. Okay. Okay, please continue.
Okay. So currently we have set up connection diagram here based on this connection diagram. So we have one KVM over IP switch, which is a KN4116. And then we have a few CPU module, which is a HDMI. So this one is connected to the, actually now it's a 2PC. So we want to show the feature which Dimas mentioned earlier, which is a multi-port from the same PC with a dual video output. So we have 2 PCs actually. Okay, and then we have 2 consoles. One console is a dual output console, which is a KA8288. And then we have another console, which is a KA8270. Okay, so we'll change the screen to our setup. So, share the screen. Okay, Dimas, I think you can stop sharing.
Okay.
Okay, so I hope everyone can see the screen. Okay, so what we have here right now is...
Okay, so what you're seeing on your screen, main screen right now is actually the console login for the KA console. Okay. So as I mentioned just now, there is actually 2 monitors from 1 console and another console, which is a single monitor. So one of the features which actually Dimas ran through just now is you can have a boundless switch. So you can connect 2 consoles and have a multi output, so up to 4 displays. Okay. So right now you can see my mouse, I can actually move across to here, like across to here also. I only have 1 keyboard, 1 mouse. I can manage up to 4 displays. Okay, so let me log in to the console. So when I log into the console, you can see actually I have a panel array or display shown on the screen. So I think you can see on your output. Okay, so right now what is it showing is it's showing our KN. So the KVM switch and all the ports is actually being cycled through. So I can actually customize this layout. So if I have multiple devices, I can actually have multiple devices being shown here. Or else if I only want to look at the ports, which is connected to the single KVM. So I can actually go to my devices. Okay. I can show this view. So this view is actually showing only the KN. So it's showing all the ports connected to the KN itself. So let's say I want to have access to these servers which I have connected to in the KVM switch. So I can select here. So let's say I want to send my 3rd display as a port number 3. So I click port 3 here. So you can see over here it's actually connected to port 3. So on my 3rd screen. Okay. Then on my secondary display, let's say I want to connect to port 2. Okay, click on port 2. Now you notice that actually both of my display changes. This is because we have configured the KVM switch with a multi-view port. That means this is actually considered as 1 device or 1 PC, 1 server. Okay, so this is an extended display. So it's a A and B. There's 2 screens here. Okay. So what I want to show is I can actually do a boundless switch. So I can actually move across. Okay. So you can see I'm still connected to the same server. And then my display is actually dragged across. Okay. I bring back here again. Yeah. So this is for the boundless switch. So you can have up to 4 monitors, and then the layout can also be configured. So if you have a different monitor set up, you can actually have a 2 monitors on top and 2 monitors below as well. Yeah. Okay. So we will proceed to the next feature, which is actually the multi view. So the multi view, what we have is as what Dimas mentioned. What? Is everyone still following me? Okay, so I hope everyone was still following me, because I'm not sure whether you caught the previous what I was talking about. Okay, so right now actually we want to share the feature, which is a multi view, which is a grouping of a multi display output server into one access. So this is actually what you're seeing on the screen is a KVM switch UI. So you can see that we have a KN4116 KVM switch here. It has up to 16 devices that can be connected to the KVM switch, and four being is a 4 remote access. Okay, so I can do an association for the port over here, which I can select any one of the PC or server connected. So actually this is a dongle. I can click on the port configuration and go to multi view. So right now you can see that we have configured port 1 and port 2 is tied to one output. So it's a one session. And the orientation is such that there's one screen on the left and one screen on the right. So that's why when I selected the source to connect into port 1, it actually switched both my display. Okay, so this is a multi-view feature. So you can actually have a different layout and a different configuration as well. And then when you select or when you go into that particular port, you actually connect accordingly. Yeah. So you can see A on the left and B on the right. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So I think with that being said, we have come to the end of the demo for the new features. If you have more questions, you can actually write to us, or you can also come down to our office to have a demo session if required.